Praise God. Lord's so good, isn't he? You know, I woke up this morning and it's so awesome how it's true. Psalms 133, when we gather together, man, in unity, God just blesses us and shows up and blesses your neighbor sitting next to you and all that good stuff. And I woke up this morning just knowing, and I couldn't really put words to it until I got here, really, how I was feeling. But I woke up this morning just feeling a note of victory. Praise God.
Amen.
And, you know, there's been a lot of prophetic words and a lot of visions and dreams and messages spoken and things like that through numerous amount of Christians the past couple years and more so just this year since January. There's been a lot of stuff prophesied and spoken over the church, spoken over not just this church I'm talking about, but the body of Christ, the church in whole. There's been words spoken. There's been things, you know, about things shifting. There's been things about wind, the winds of God blowing. There's been things about shaking. There's been things about fire. There's been things about just going to another level, and just our territories are expanding, and God is raising up an army, and all this stuff. We've been hearing a lot of stuff, especially since the first of this year. And all of it excites me, it blesses me, and it's just like this morning when I woke up, it was like a knowing, like, man, we are, and even though the Word of God says this, I know this, but it's like, when you get a hold, listen, there's some, let me explain it this way. You can read the Word of God, and I've done this many times, where I've read the Word of God, and I've never really got the full revelation of what I was reading, sometimes. Have you ever been there and done that, you know? But then you read it again, like for the 13th time, 15th time, and it's like, boom, there it is. I understand that now. Or you hear someone teach on it, and you get that revelation from the Holy Spirit on that. And that's what I feel like is happening right now with the body of Christ in general. I really feel like we have come out of our slumber. We've all been guilty of it. We've come out of our slumber. We've rose to the occasion. We've rose to how God has wanted us to rise. We've got some revelation. The Bible says that a word spoken in due season is like apples of gold. And there's been a lot of words that have been spoken over the body of Christ, maybe to you personally, as an individual, about what God's called you to do, or about your family or something. And there's been words that have been spoken to the body of Christ in general, as a whole. And I'm telling you guys that we have came to another level. We are going to another level in the glory, in the kingdom. Praise God. The battle is not ours, but it's the Lord's. But He will use your mouth for praise. And He can use your mouth for war.
Yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Amen.
He can use your mouth for war. What happened when they stood there and shouted, "For the Lord is good, and His mercies endure forever"?
Yes.
The enemy turned on themselves.
Yeah.
He used the Word of God, but He used also praise and war out of their mouths.
Yes.
Sounds kind of like a two-edged sword coming out of your mouth.
Yes.
We have come into a place. Now, it's my prayer, and it's my hope, and it's my belief, and it's what I want to see. I want to see every believer on the face of the earth rise to the occasion and be what God has called them to be on this earth while they're here. That is my prayer. It really is. It really is. Now, I know that we won't know everything all the time. We don't need to know everything all the time. We just need to stay hooked into God, stay hooked into our Father, and let the Holy Spirit, let God speak to the Holy Spirit, and let the Holy Spirit speak to us, and let Him not only speak to us, but let Him reveal Himself through us as we walk on this earth, as we follow Christ, and as you are in the army of God. Folks, we have received the note of victory. God's word has never, now I want you to get a hold of that. Receive the note of victory today. We have got, God's word will never fail. It will never be destroyed. It will never cease. The word of God is forever. The kingdom of God is forever. Be a kingdom dweller.
Amen.
Dwell in the kingdom now.
Amen.
This morning, I don't, listen, very spiritual person, and I pray that you are too. You should be. Now, it's important what kind of spirit you're yielding to, amen? That's important. But I know that I know that I know in my spirit today that there has been, it would be cool to know what happened in other services around the earth today or in this nation. If there was other places like this today that was happening. There was something in here this morning. I walked into this building today, and it was like I knew that I could jump through the roof and run through the wall. That's how I felt in the spirit. That's how I felt in the spirit. I felt an excitement. I felt victory.
Amen.
Some of you grew up playing sports. How did it feel when you got your butt kicked in a game? You know, it didn't feel very good. Walk off with your head hanging, no matter how many times the coach said, it's okay, bud, you did a good job today. You didn't feel like you did a good job today. You just got handed, you know what I mean? But that feeling of victory is so sweet. It's so precious. It's so exciting. And the devil tries to use distraction to get us off what God has already said about you as an individual, about your families, about the kingdom business that he has for you to do here. He tries to get you off that, but stay focused on that. I know that we have advanced today. I know that this body here has advanced. And if you're in the body of Christ, you have advanced not only personally, but also corporately.
Yes.
So go. You have the ball. The ball is in your hand. The ball is in your court. You have it. Go with it. Don't let the devil hold you back. Yeah, but I've been out of church for a while, or I just don't feel. It don't matter how long, how you feel. That doesn't matter. God has already called us.
Amen.
We're called for greatness. Wow. Arise and shine, for your light has come,
yeah.
And the glory of the Lord is risen upon you. Those darkness will cover the earth, but the Gentiles will see the glory rising upon you.
Yeah.
That word glory, that means they're going to see a light shining on you.
Amen.
Yes. Isaiah chapter 60. That's what it says. I'm getting excited about that this morning. Praise God. I shouted so much during praise and worship, I can hardly talk right now. But it's good. We don't have nothing to be concerned about. And I say that, study the children of Israel. What God did for them. What God's doing right now. I really believe that there's been a lot of stuff over the past several years that God has allowed to happen in our country. Because us, Christians, have been sleeping. Us, you notice I said us? We've been sleeping in certain areas. And I really believe that the church is really starting to wake up in some areas, and they're starting to realize that God loves Israel, that God hates abortion, that God hates sexual perversion, that it's an abomination to him, and all the other stuff. Pride, you know what one of the biggest sins is? Is pride, really. That's really what the biggest one. I don't need to change. I can figure it out. I can do it myself. God can't help me. I can do this on my own. I'm a self-made man. If I believe that lie, I'd already be dead by now, probably. True. God, there's such a stench of hell in this nation. And I don't blame so much all the demons for it. I don't blame so much all the people that aren't born again for it. I blame the church a lot. I blame us. We've let it just go. Because a lot of people, a lot of Christians, a lot of preachers want money. They want fame. They want fortune. They want to be known. And instead of telling the truth, they're soothsayers. And they just say whatever it takes to keep Daddy Big Bucks in the pew.
That's true. It's true, man.
I can stand up here and preach this today because I've judged my heart in this area already. Whether you Like me or not, whether you think I'm full of it or not, doesn't matter. I know what I've done in my heart already about the money and about the fame and about all the fortune and all that stuff. I've already said no to all of it. I don't even want to, I don't care who knows. It doesn't matter to me. I just want to do what God's called me to do. That's all I care about. I want to love people, preach the truth, share them with them in love. Some will receive, some won't. That's why Jesus said when you go into the home and they don't receive you, clean your shoes off, clean your feet off, put your shoes on and hit the road. There's nothing you can do about it. Except keep your heart pure, love them, and just preach the gospel of Jesus.
Come on.
But see, the church, we've been lazy about this. But listen, I'm not here to... Man, I thought we had victory, guys. I'm sharing why, where we've been and why we've been there. And why things are going the way they are in this nation. I don't care what the history books say, this nation was found on God.
Yes.
And I want to tell you something right now. I am so proud of my hometown that I live in right now, Madera, California.
Man, that's right.
The town and the county. Because of what they've put in our county... in our county board of advisors room and what they put in the city council room.
Hallelujah!
On the wall right behind them. Some of you have already seen it. Woo! In God we trust. Hallelujah. That's a statement!
Yes, it is.
That's a statement.
Yes.
What are we saying? Maybe not everybody's saying this, but what are we saying? We're saying, God, we put you first in this county. God, we put you first in this city. That makes us so primed for revival. That makes us so primed for such a mighty wave move of God to sweep across here and to save souls and the harvest to come in. That's the statement being made right there. It isn't just a saying. It is serious. We're saying to God, God, we trust you in our county. We trust you in our city, God. Come be in this county. Come be in this city. Have your way in this city, this county, God. That's what it says to God. That's a huge step. There has been, now what I was talking about earlier about us waking up, there's been a lot of intercession going on. I know there has. You can read about it every day on the internet. Somehow, on Elijah List or some kind of deal, other ministries, that they've been getting together and praying and praying and praying during the week for our country, for this world, for everything, every issue that's going on right now, they've been praying for. Just us. We've been going at it since early 2014 here on Tuesday mornings. We've been praying, and I'm going to say probably 95% of the prayers that we've prayed for the past 2.5 years or so it's been, that we have prayed, has been for our nation. That's where God has us. 95% of the time when we get in here for that morning prayer, it's been about our nation. And since we've been praying that, God has been speaking to individuals, giving us dreams, visions. He's been saying things to us, prophetically revealing things to us about our nation. And one of the things that God revealed to me, and a vision that I had, and some of you, I've shared it here before, but I feel like I need to share it again this morning. I didn't come willing or even prepared to share it, but I just feel like the Lord wants me to do it as I'm standing up here. April 16th, we were having prayer on a Tuesday morning here, and I was sitting in the back there, and there was some travail going on and some groanings and weeping in the spirit that was going on with a few people that were here praying. And one of the ladies had just got done. It was like she was giving birth. God was using her to give birth into something in the spirit. And as soon as it got done, all of a sudden I went into this vision while I was sitting back there. And I saw this lady, and she was standing, and she was holding a baby bear, a cub. Kind of a coincidence is the Cubs won this year. But anyways, I'll just let that later. But anyways, she was holding this baby cup. And I was standing around in this vision, and I was looking at this lady, and I thought, why in the world is she holding a baby bear? So I took a few steps and walked over to it, and I kind of leaned over her shoulder and looked at this baby bear, and the baby bear was asleep. And his eyes were closed, and it wasn't moving, and this lady was holding it like he would hold a baby. And I started to say something. When I started to say something, the bear's eyes opened, shut open. And it startled me in the vision. And I backed up like, wow. And the vision was over. And I'm standing back there. I'm like, Lord, that is really weird. Like, why would you show me that? What does that have to do with anything? I asked him just like that. Within 10 minutes, he answered me. And he said, I heard California flag.
Yep.
Wow.
Okay. Immediately I know there's a bear on our California flag.
Yeah.
And I said, okay, so I saw the significance there between the bear, while she was holding a cub and it grew into a bear. And then I obviously received California out of that as well. He was trying to say something about California to me. And I said, well, what does that have to do with that bear? And he said, his eyes open because he's awakened.
Yeah,
right. California has awakened.
That's right. Yeah.
Hallelujah.
It might not look like it. It might not sound like it.
Sure.
I don't care what it looks like. I don't care what it sounds like. All I care is what he says about it.
Right.
What he says about it. And I'm sure, and I've heard since then, I've heard other people talk about kind of similar visions or dreams that they've had about California with the similarities of that vision. And what God was saying to me was, California, that baby bear represented a newness. Babies are new.
Yeah.
New beginnings. And it woke up. It became awake. It awoke.
Yeah.
And so God began to show me about California because the people have been praying. And this was right after the Azusa thing that was held down there in L.A. It was just a few days after. And God showed me this. And that stirred me so much to the core. It was like he gave me he gave me a mandate almost, or a command to speak what he showed me that day.
Yeah.
Isaiah 21:6 says, you stand your watch on the wall, and you speak whatever it is that God shows you, it says.
Yeah.
Isaiah 21:6. You speak it. Guys, I don't care how long you've been a Christian. If you've only been a Christian for 1 month, 2 months, 55 years, doesn't matter. Your job is to be a watchman.
Right.
You are to be a voice, a mouthpiece for the living God.
Amen.
That is your voice. That is your duty. And when God shows you something about something, you speak it. I've been around a lot of awesome Christians my whole life. I've been so blessed to be raised in this church and around the body of believers over the years. Some of them are gone now. Some of them are still here. You know, you're here, praise God. I've been around a lot of ministers and things like that where I've been able to hear them teach on faith, and I've been able to hear them teach on your mouth and how to use your mouth. And guys, I want to tell you right now, one of the most powerful things besides the blood of the Lamb on this earth is your mouth.
Yeah.
It's big.
It is.
I guess I shouldn't have said it that way. Let it be big in the spirit. How's that?
Yeah.
I've had my mouth get myself in trouble before. Have you?
Yeah.
It's been big in the natural sometimes. I've said things, this and that, but let it be big in the spirit, praise God.
Amen.
Proverbs 18, death and life from the power of the tongue, praise God. Good or bad.
Amen.
I've been constantly, weekly reminding myself, God, I don't want to curse situations. I want to speak life. I want to speak blessing. When I find myself getting critical or start to speak about a situation or somebody, I just want God to arrest me. Really, I really do. Because our mouths are so huge in the Spirit. And God can get a lot of work done if you'll just yield to the Holy Ghost.
Amen.
You know, like Dad says, don't go and give people a piece of your mind because it might be your last piece. Keep all you got. Keep it all. I found out you can get a lot farther by praying for somebody behind closed doors and speaking over somebody than you can trying to wrestle them into the kingdom. Or you can't try to wrestle them out of the problems they're going through or the addictions they're going through.
Wow.
You can get a lot more done by speaking to the Spirit that's controlling them.
That's right.
Amen.
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 Guys, that's why I'm here where I'm at today right now, because I have parents and grandparents and family and friends that spoke against the Spirit that was trying to take me out.
That's right.
That's right. Amen.
Just speaking. Amen.
Amen.
It's our duty as Christians and as God followers, as Christ followers, to speak against the evil, to come against darkness, and to not allow it to affect our generation, our region. It is up to us, guys. We don't fight in the natural.
Amen.
We fight in the spirit.
Yes.
What am I trying to say today? I'm trying to say today, what are you saying about your situations?
Amen.
What are you saying about your country? What are you saying about your neighborhood? I've been so guilty of getting angry at my neighbors and things like that, I've had to repent majorly over that. What are we saying? And let me ask this question too. This is huge right here. This is going to get some of you thinking. Who are you aligning yourself with spiritually?
Yeah, you can align
with
the word. That's a good word right there.
Amen.
Wow.
Yes.
Better read the word.
Hallelujah. That's big.
Amen.
You could have a bestest friend. BFFs. Best friends forever. You can have one of those. And they could be going the totally opposite direction you're going, and you're aligning yourself with them. That's scary. It's not good. It's dangerous. Some folks, you'll have to leave. Some folks you'll be with forever as you walk your spiritual journey on this earth. I understand that. God wants to maybe bring some new folks into your life as the days go on. We got to be very aware of what we're fellowshipping with. That's so big. Because I'm going to tell you something. I know this for a fact, and I know that a lot of you are going to agree with me when I say this. But if you're constantly looking at stuff that's violent, you're going to act violent.
Yeah.
Your mind will be violent.
Yeah, right.
Maybe your hands or your feet or your body will be violent. Your mouth will be violent. It's a spiritual thing. Now listen, I know every single person in here, we have made mistakes. We have maybe been deceived in certain areas in our lives, in our minds. Things maybe we weren't taught or didn't get a hold of when we were growing up or something like that. We've all done things that we're not proud of. We've all done things that we've blown it and made mistakes, and thank God for the blood of Jesus. Thank God He really truly does forgive us of our sins and cleanse us from all righteousness. That's our hope, amen? That's what keeps me going, because I know God loves me, and that blood is on that mercy seat there for me and for us. Thank God for that. But we have got to continue, and Dad preached this a couple weeks ago, we've got to continue to judge our hearts. We've got to continue to come before God, just like King David did, and say, God, look at my heart. I judge myself, God. I don't want anything unclean in me. Who are we aligning with? Who are we giving time to? What are we giving time to? Whose counsel are we taking? So big.
That's a seasoned word.
So big. I don't pretend to know everything about the Bible. I don't pretend to know everything about what God's doing on this earth. I don't even act like I do know that, because I don't. But one thing I do know is there is life and there is death. There is heaven and there is hell. There is abominations, and then there's things that God is proud of and has created. And we have got to. Because I found myself slipping into this deal too, where it's just like a thing where it's just how the generation is, or it's how things are going, or it's how things are done now. And you know, sleeping with people before you're married, it's really not that big of a deal, because I know I'm going to marry them anyways. Or it's okay, you know, for a man or a woman that are married to look at another sex and desire that and get lost into that and develop other relationships. It's not okay. None of that's okay. That brings death. And it brings destruction. And I know some folks don't understand that. God has mercy on those people. He loves them. But when we come to the knowledge of Christ, we have got to put our flesh to death.
Amen.
Amen. Folks, I'm going to tell you, it ain't going to happen overnight. It ain't. But it is a daily thing. When your flesh wants to align with something that's not godly, you've got to allow God to crucify it. And if you do step over the line, you repent quickly and you get back over where you are at. Because we can't do that. I'm not saying go do whatever you want. That's not what I'm saying. There's things in all of us that is under construction right now. Come on. Allow God. That's my prayer for us today as the body. Allow the Lord to do construction in our lives. Allow Him to rip out and unroot things in us that we've allowed to be rooted either by ignorance or we just didn't understand or just willfully we did it anyways out of rebellion. There's been roots put in us that aren't of God. Allow Him to do it.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you. Hallelujah, man. Come on, Lord. Just cleanse us from all of it.
Yes.
Heal us, heal our land.
So good, Lord.
He's so good. There's been a lot of intercession going on, a lot of prayer. God has been talking to the body of Christ. He's been talking to us, guys. He's been talking to us. And I know that our flesh, that in the natural, we want to get riled up sometimes and we don't understand certain things and we say certain things or we act a certain way or something like that. But what God is doing, see, listen, He created all of us warriors. He really did. He created us to fight in the Spirit. He created us to praise and to worship and to get over into the Spirit to where if you see the enemy's doing something, you come against it in the Spirit. You don't come against that person. You come against the spirit that's dominating that person.
Yes, amen.
And you stand your ground and you say, you will take your hands off my son, my daughter, my family, my brother, my sister in Christ. You will take your hands off. And they will have clarity and they will have wisdom and knowledge and revelation of what's going on with them in their life. This Tuesday. This Tuesday.
Yeah.
I'm not talking about Republican. I'm not talking about Democrat. I'm talking about a Christ follower. Christians. Who will you align yourself with this Tuesday? See, I feel the arrogant type here right now. I start talking about that. People can't handle it. I'm pro-Israel. I'm pro-life.
Right. Amen.
Amen.
I'm against sexual perversion.
Amen.
And most of all, I'm for God.
Amen.
Amen.
And He's serious about all three of those issues.
Amen.
Very serious.
Amen.
And I'm not going to be held accountable.
Amen.
For that.
That's powerful.
I say that in love. But I say that very serious today.
Yeah.
We better look at who we're sowing into. That's big. The shed of innocent blood is huge. And if you're in this place and you've had an abortion, if you repent, God forgives you. He loves you. I love you. We all have done things in our lives. But it's the continuing of it.
Exactly.
To allow it.
That's exactly
the issue.
Come on.
Abel's blood cries out.
Come on.
The Bible says.
Yeah.
The shedding of innocent blood is heavy in our nation. It's not just about abortion, it's about all the other things that have been done. I really believe it's come to a time in our nation where the lines have been drawn. Dark and light.
Amen.
Church, pray for me that I'm the one having to stand up here and talk about this today. Because I know this ain't... I'm not popular anyway, so I won't get a bunch of hate mail. That's for it. So that's fine. But where are you at right now? That's what we've got to look at. Where is this nation? Guys, we have the truth. There is no other way to the Father God but through Jesus Christ.
Amen. Right.
Amen.
That's the truth.
Yes.
And the reason why I know it's the truth is because of you guys. Because it's in you, He's in you, the love's in you, the glory's on you right now, the presence of God's in this place right now as I even talk about this subject.
Amen.
That victory that we were sensing this morning,
That
victory is in the spirit, but we're getting ready to see that victory in the natural.
Yeah. Yes.
Because we're getting ready to see a lot of people that have been oppressed because of the devil roaming in this land here, seeking whom he may devour, the Bible says. Because of the people that have been oppressed by him, we're getting ready to see that victory spring forth in the natural. We're going to see a lot of people that were bound in chains and didn't understand. They did not understand.
Right.
What they were involved in, what was going on with them, they didn't know because the devil had them deceived. We're going to see them come out of darkness, and we're going to even see that victory in the natural. I believe that. We all know that it isn't going to, a person didn't save us. We understand that. Jesus Christ did. We know that there's no man, no woman, no anything that can save us but Jesus. We understand that.
Amen. Amen.
But we get done what needs to get done in this nation by the Spirit.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Now, listen. There's so many things, and I know that there's a lot of people in here today that you're sitting there going, man, there's so many things that we could talk about for hours today.
Yeah.
We could talk about this for hours, about our nation and how the enemy is really doing some damage, has been doing damage because of ignorance and because of decisions that people have made because they've been deceived by the enemy. We understand that. I'm not putting my hope in any human being. It's obvious. But mom is always talking about platforms. What are they for and what are they against? That's the only choice we have. That's the only choice we have.
Yeah.
I don't get involved with all the stuff that's all the mudslinging that's going on in this nation.
Yeah.
What it comes down to is the truth. Mm-hmm. What does the Word say about these circumstances?
Right.
What does the Word say about this? What does the Word say about that? That's how I make my decision. That's how Christians should make their decision. It's the truth. Sure, there's things that anger me. Sure, there's things that I think are totally uncalled for, and they're totally childish, and totally goofiness, and totally just absurdity. But, what does the Word say?
Yeah.
That's the only thing I can base my faith on. That's it. That's it. I'm telling you, we are, as a body, guys, we have gotten so stronger as a corporate body. I know this since the beginning of the year, the body of Christ has gotten stronger. There's been more unity than I've ever seen in the body of Christ. I've seen it. Just talking with people that aren't from here, from other states and other things, and hearing things that they're saying about the believers in their community and the things how they're rising up and they're coming together. They're walking in love. They're walking in forgiveness. And they're letting things be left on the ground and they're joined together because they serve the one and true God and that's what they're looking to. I really want to say this to you today. I really believe this, that the body of Christ is rising. And the word of the Lord says, and we've heard it earlier, Isaiah 60, that we have arose and we are shining because the glory of the Lord is upon us, and the gross darkness will cover the earth. We'll see it. But we don't have to worry about it or
that's
be inferior.
Right,
because there's going to be people that are involved in that darkness that's going to see the glory on us, and they're going to come out of that and come to the light and come into the glory.
Yeah.
That's hope right there.
Yeah.
That's something good to be excited about. That's something good to thank God for. That's something good to live in faith and receive by faith, because it is the word of the Lord. And I truly believe that what seed you sow on Tuesday, you will eat of that seed.
Amen.
Don't hate me. Don't try to puff my head up with thanks for saying that. Just believe it, because it's the truth.
Amen.
Amen and amen.
And I didn't even make it up or say it or come up with that. So you can't hold me accountable for anything. The word of God says it. Whatever you sow into it. Whatever you sow into it. I learned at a young age. I've taught my children at a young age to sow into the kingdom.
Amen.
And he meets every need. He takes care of us every time. We never lack anything. He always does it for us. He always does it for us. He goes after it. Gets it for us. Blesses us. Sow into the kingdom. Sow into the kingdom.
Amen.
And listen to the Holy Ghost. Listen to the Holy Ghost. He'll never lead you in the wrong direction. The Holy Ghost will make you look like a genius, man. The Holy Ghost will have people going, how did you know that about me? Because the Lord told me you're ready to be healed. Bam, and you get healed. People get healed. The Holy Spirit loves people. He wants to help folks. Guys, I was going to read about Jehoshaphat. Well, you know, think about King Jehoshaphat for just a second. When they came with the news saying these armies were getting ready to attack, what are you going to do, King?
Yeah.
You know what he did? He aligned himself with the Father. And he went into the temple. He went into the church building. He went into his place. And he got before the Lord. And he said, God, what do we do?
Amen.
He chose to align himself immediately with the one that was going to take care of him.
Yes, hallelujah.
God said, just get out there. They called a fast. They came and they prayed. They spent time. They aligned themselves to the Lord. The Lord gave them the direction to go. They went out and they stood there. And he said, shout praise. They began to do that. The enemy destroyed themselves.
Yes.
The devil's kingdom is blowing up as we speak. He's losing ground. He's not gaining. He's losing. That's why the past 3, 4, 5, 6 years of your life have been the hardest it's ever been before. Because he knows. You guys got to get a revelation of this today. Grab a hold of this. He knows where you're headed. He knows where you're headed as an individual. He knows where you're headed as a family unit. He knows where you're headed as a corporate body, as a brother and sister, as a son and a child of God. He knows where you're headed. That's why he's attacked. And I'm telling you right now that it's over with, that God is prevailing, we are rising, and we are going to take this earth and this nation by force, by the love of God. Praise God. That's what love is going to do. Love is going to dominate.
Yes. Yes.
Amen.
Be dominated by love.
Yes.
Every door will open for you if you'll keep your heart dominated by love.
Yes.
You'll be able to accomplish everything God called you to accomplish. You'll be able to do everything God's called you to do if you'll keep your heart dominated by the love of God.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord. King Jehoshaphat aligned himself with God right off the bat. God showed him what to do. told him how to do it. One thing I will say, and this is the absolute truth, if God be for us, who can be against us?
That's right.
Come on.
Amen.
David walked out there. He let that sucker go. Boom. Right between the eyes. That giant that was trying to intimidate him and his people, keep him from where they needed to go. Disease is a giant. Don't let it intimidate you. Kick it out and go where God has called you to go. Sickness, disease, that's just a giant. The devil's trying to use to keep you. Some of you are dealing with sickness and disease right now in this place. It's a giant. The devil has sinned against you. You plead the blood, you know the covenant you have with God.
That's right.
You tell him to get out.
That's right.
See, David didn't tell Goliath to get out. He just killed him and took care of it that quick and made it easy. Didn't have to wait for him to pack. Didn't have to wait for him to rally up all his buddies to leave the land. He just killed him, cut his head off, picked his head up and showed everybody, and then the other brothers eventually ended up getting killed and all that. They're trying to intimidate still. But see, it makes it easier when you use the blood of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. I know that sounds kind of, but it's the truth.
Amen.
Use your mouth for praise and use your mouth for war.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Glory! We got the victory!
Yes.
We used to sing a song right here. I'm so glad that Jesus set me free. Glory, hallelujah, Jesus set me free. Satan thought he had me bound, but Jesus set me free. Satan thought he had me bound, but Jesus set me free.
Yes.
Glory, hallelujah, Jesus set me free. I'm on my way to heaven and I'm shouting
victory.
I'm on my way to heaven and I'm shouting victory. On my way to heaven, and I'm shouting victory, singing glory, hallelujah, Jesus has set me free.
Amen.
That's all. Guys, I'm looking at a bunch of people that aren't afraid. I can see in their eyes. Come on, don't bite me. It's a group. Come on. I'm looking at a bunch of people that are victorious. I really am. By the blood of Christ. We're victorious in
Him. Amen.
Do everything is under the Lord. Keep Him first. Keep Him first. Some of us have been in valleys over the recent years. Some of you feel like you've just been at the lowest of the low. You know, maybe you're going through something right now. You just keep speaking the word. You keep speaking faith. You keep speaking what Jesus has already done for you. You keep speaking the word. If you have to say it, the Bible tells us to mutter it over and over and over again. To constantly speak the word when you're going through a test and going through a trial.
Yeah.
To speak it. The words, the blood of Jesus and the word of the Lord has delivered us. We are delivered into the hands of our God. He has us. That high priest, Jesus. I'm going to close right now. Psalms 37 says this. That God sits in the heavens and He laughs.
Right.
At the wicked schemes, the schemes of the evil people.
That's right.
Because He knows that it will not stand. That is a house of the fall.
That's
right. Yes. Psalms 37, if you read that chapter, it's kind of like the time we're living in right now.
Yeah.
You read, I promise you, if you read it, Psalms 37, you'll see. It's like you're like right now, like it was written right now. Of what's going on. But God sits in the heavens and He laughs. He's full of joy.
Yeah.
Because He knows His words are being performed. And there's a people, us, that is allowing the word of God to be performed through us. Guys, I love you so much. I really do. I honestly do love you. I really do. And I'm thankful to be a pastor here. I'm thankful to have you here as my family. And I'm telling you, guys, we are winning.
Come on.
We are victorious through the blood of Christ.
Amen.
The devil in hell is going to destroy my family, our families.
That's right.
He's not going to take our ministries. He's not going to take the gifts and the equippings that God has gifted us with and equipped us with. He's not going to do it because we're rising up and we're saying no to him and we're saying yes to him. And we're moving forward like an army.
Yes. Hallelujah.
No, that's what it sounds like. And every time we step, we hear, because we're stepping on the wall. Jesus told us that, right? The devil's under your feet. I'm giving you power to trample on demons and powers of darkness. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Say it, Brother Ted.
Hallelujah.
Come on. Glory. Glory to God. We win, guys. We have victory. By the blood of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
You know what's going to be so awesome is we get to seal this today with communion. We're going to take communion right now. We're going to take communion. And I really feel like this. Well, we're going to get prepared to pass out the cracker and the juice, the body and the blood of the Lord. Amen. As I do that, I really feel like today's communion service today, you know, I'm getting ready to say it, don't you? I really feel like it's for our nation.
Yes.
Amen.
We didn't talk about that. It just came to me right now by the Spirit of God. This is for our nation today. That we, go ahead, guys. Go ahead and feel free to pass out. That we are standing with the body and the blood of the Lord for our nation. We are recognizing what Jesus did, not only for us personally, but for our nation. That the blood of Christ will be applied. And here's the deal. The Bible says that Paul said that there were many that were weak, that were sick, that were dying. Because they didn't discern the body and the blood of the Lord. They didn't take this serious. They thought it was just a fairy tale or some kind of deal. But folks, I have seen so many lives changed because of the body and the blood of the Lord, including myself. I've seen people get healed of diseases and sickness, discerning the body and the blood of the Lord. So not only for you today, as you believe God and as you spend time with the Lord right now privately between you and Him concerning this communion, this cup, and this bread, but also you look into your heart today, look into your spirit today concerning our nation, and if there's something the Lord reveals to you or wants you to pray while you're sitting there, and to apply the blood and to apply the body of the blood of the body and the blood of the Lord over this nation, that I want you to do that. So I just want to give everyone some time here just to sit before the Lord and just listen to your heart concerning this.
I just wanted to say something real quick first. Several years ago, Prophet Larry Huggins, who comes to our church, has been a prophet to this church for many years. God spoke to him and told him, I want you to take this year and I want you to go to every state capital in the United States, all 50 state capitals. He went throughout the states one a week, went to one state capital per week. The last one was in Washington, D.C. on the Capitol steps. He said, I want you to go and I want you to get Christians that will come and go with you in that area. And I want you to offer up communion. To stand on the steps of the government house of that state and to worship God and offer up communion. Now, Sacramento, our capital, who knows what Sacramento means? The sacrament, the body and blood of the Lord. The land that our state capital sits on was given to our state by the Catholic Church. And, you know, the enemy will try to tell you what your state is, that God already years before has established. And this is the Holy Ghost, I know it is, because I was sitting over there thinking, how am I going to get up there and tell him we're going to receive communion as intercession for our nation? See, that's what we did. I went up there with Brother Larry. I don't know, were you there that day, Mike?
No, I did not.
You didn't go up at that. But we were up there. There was a good number of Christians. some demon-possessed guy went nuts and came running across the street, cussing at us, telling us we didn't belong there. We were disturbing his peace, he said. And I looked at the person next to me and said, well, I guess we know what the devil thinks about this little meeting here. But we weren't there, you know, to necessarily receive communion for ourselves. We were there to say, Lord, it's your body and your blood, it's the cross. It's only the blood of Jesus that can turn our nation back to you fully soaked. And why? So we can fulfill our destiny as a nation and be a part of the great harvest of souls that's going to come in. So today, of course, you receive it by faith for yourself. If you're sick in body today or you need something from the Lord, you receive that as the Lord, you know, as you receive this before the Lord today. But as a group today, I want us to receive this in intercessory. It's intercessory prayer, really, is what it is. We're saying, Lord, we're not looking at us, we're not looking at politicians, we're not looking at a party, we're not looking at anything natural to be, even though you'll use all those elements in turning our nation around, we're looking to you, and we know that you are the only answer. What Jesus did at the cross is what can fix our nation. So let's receive it in that spirit today. Mike said he wanted me to go ahead and pray. You know, I just feel like we need to stand up.
Yes. Amen.
Come on.
Yes. Just stand up. Lord, from the start of the service today, you brought us into a place of unity and victory. God, I know that you always are victorious. Your word says, thanks be unto God who always causes us to triumph in Christ Jesus. And so as we stand here today, I think everyone in this world, even those that don't know Christ, are sensing there's a major shift, a major change happening in the world. Some are fearful about it. Others are excited about it. And others just don't even know about it. But God, I thank you that you are our God. And that you established this nation as all the other nations of the world and the earth to do what you called us to do as a nation. Lord, I know, because I know what you've shown me and I've heard what others have said as well, what your word says in James, that you, like a farmer, have been very patient watching the harvest grow and come to fruition. And you are about to release a mighty harvest, thrusting your people into that harvest. And we refuse to let the land that you've given us to not participate in that harvest. And so, Father, we don't stand here in our own righteousness, our own self-righteousness. We don't stand here, Father, even boasting on our prayer life or any other thing. But, God, we look to you based on what Jesus Christ did for every person that would ever live on the cross of Calvary. I thank you that his body was broken, that our body might be made whole. His body was broken that the church might be in unity. His body was broken that the United States of America would be indivisible before you, Lord. God, the separations, the divisions that are here now, only you can heal that. And so we look to the body of Christ. We look to that sacrifice of his body being broken for the unity of this United States. And so we receive this by faith today, and as it goes into our mouth, we decree and we declare that unity around you in who you are, and love and support and help for all peoples. The love of God, Father, may that be predominant in this nation, and may mercy and truth kiss each other and be together, Father, as you bring about the healing of our land, in Jesus' name. You may receive the body together.
Hallelujah.
Lord, we praise you and thank you for your blood. When I think of your blood, I don't think of a red substance or even a little juice in a glass like this. I think of the life and the light of God. You are light.
Thank you, Lord.
And your life is light, the word says in John. Lord, we thank you that the blood of Jesus is something the enemy cannot approach or stand against. He has no answer for this. So, Lord, we do not plead anything except your blood. Father God, we come before your throne You are the judge of all the earth, and you will do what's right. And we plead what Jesus, our intercessor, our great high priest, is standing there right now. And he is speaking on our behalf what the blood is speaking. The blood is speaking freedom. The blood is speaking forgiveness. The blood is speaking that there can be a divine turnaround, and that the fulfillment of what you've intended from the eternities of before this will come to pass in every life that's intended, Father. Every life that opens up its heart to you. And so right now we plead the blood over our nation from the top of government all the way to the bottom. We plead it over the schools. We plead it over families. We plead it over business. We plead it over the entertainment industry. We plead it, Father God, over every sphere, every mountain, every part, every individual. And we receive your blood today. And we offer it before you today for intercession, as intercession for our nation. And we thank you for the divine turnaround by the blood of Jesus Christ. You may receive together.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Father, for turning our nation around. Thank you, Father, for healing our land. Thank you for healing our land, Father. We thank you for healing our land. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Amen.
Amen. That's good. Let me see it just for a couple more minutes. We want to receive our harvest offering. We do that once a month. And we feed, I don't know, how many food boxes do we usually give out monthly? How many? Usually around between 34 and 40 food boxes we give weekly. No, month.
Weekly.
That's weekly that we give. Here on Thursdays, this money goes towards that. We're able to get food boxes for people. We're able to clothe people. It's so awesome. God is blessing the people in our community through us. And so that's what a lot of this money goes towards. It also goes into just other needs and things that are needed around here for people and stuff. So just give today into that offering. Go ahead, guys, and take it. You don't need to wait for me when you get a chance. But if you need an envelope, just lift your hand. But it's our harvest offering. Praise God. We try to do as much as we can in this city concerning people that have needs. And it's just a blessing to our city. Amen. Tonight, don't forget, we'll have service again tonight at 6 o'clock. Also, coming up, try to come out if you can. I really believe they're going to bless you. Invite some people to come. Coming out starting Friday night, of course. We're having our prophetic purpose conference. And Henry and Grace Flaney will be with us this Friday night at 7. And then Sister Lenore Marin from Arizona is going to be with us. I really believe you guys are going to really enjoy her. She's a blessing. I've only met her one time, and I've got to hear her speak a couple times. And I really believe she's going to bring a word here for not only for us as individuals, but also for our region, our community, for what God wants to do here in the city of Madera and the surrounding areas. And that will be Saturday night at 6. She'll be with us, and then she'll be with us Sunday morning as well. So try to make plans to come on out to those meetings. I really believe there's going to be some things that are going to be said in these meetings that you're going to be able to take with you, and you're going to be able to use as warfare, praise God, and speak into this region, into this area. Amen. That's why we're doing it. Amen. Lord, we just thank you for this time of offering, Lord. We just sow this seed into your kingdom today. And Lord, thank you for using us to be a blessing to the poor, being a blessing to the needy, being a blessing to the people that are maybe struggling with some things, Lord, and they need help, Lord. We're thankful to do that. We're so thankful that we can do that, Lord. And we just thank you for mighty, mighty blessing upon this seed today in your people's lives in Jesus' name. Amen. And while they're praying, or while they're taking up this offering, let's just get an agreement in prayer. There's a couple prayer requests here that we have. There's a lady by the name of Colleen that's going through thyroid cancer. We want to pray for her today. And also, there's a young child named Charlie that's having some struggle in his life, in his body, so we want to pray for him. And also, there's a situation that someone had brought to my attention this morning that there's a man that's just really giving them, one of their neighbors is giving them a hard time and real hateful, and so we just want to pray for that person. Amen? Amen. Let's stand up. Praise the Lord. Let's get in agreement and pray here. And if there's someone on your heart that you're thinking of, just speak life and peace over their lives in Jesus' name. Lord, we lift up these prayer requests right now, Father. Lord, I thank you that, Father God, you answer prayer. You truly answer prayer. That's why we're all standing here today. Hallelujah.
Yes, amen.
And you're a God of blessing, a God of love, and a God of power. So right now, we lift up Colleen. We come against this cancer. We curse this cancer. I command this cancer to leave her body in the name of Jesus Christ. Get out of Colleen's body right now in the name of Jesus. I speak life. We speak life into Colleen's body. We say live and not die. Declare the works of the Lord in the name of Jesus. Let healing power flow. Angels of healing be released to minister to her right now in the name of Jesus. And Lord, we lift up Charlie. Lord, we speak health. We speak blessing. We speak prosperity in this boy's life in the name of Jesus Christ. We command, devil, take your hands off this young man, and we say healing flow into his body right now in the name of Jesus. We thank you that Charlie will fulfill the will, the plan, and the purpose that you have for his life, God, in the name of Jesus. And Lord, we just lift this man up before you. Lord, whatever's going on with him, change his heart, God. Send someone across his pathway to minister love and truth and healing to this man in the name of Jesus. And we speak to the spirits that are controlling this man. And we say, you leave these people alone now in the name of Jesus. You shut your mouth and leave them alone in the name of Jesus Christ. We thank you for it in Jesus' name. And Lord, I speak the blessing of God. I speak the peace of God over every person in this building today, Lord. I thank you for peace. I thank you for strength. I thank you for health. I thank you for prosperity. I thank you for the life of God that lives on the inside of them today, Lord. And that we ask you to use us for your glory, Father. And we love you and we give everything to you today, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen.